Welcome back. It's been a while, but our friends Dr. Jeremy and Jen from the Roger Williams Park Zoo are back in Studio B with a friend.
Hit it, Sheba.
Look, it's little Delilah.
It's Delilah.
Little Delilah.
Can I try and feed her some meals?
Of course.
Jen, what, Jen and Dr. Jeremy, I've never seen anything quite like this.
Well, she's a red-rumped agouti.
Red-rumped agouti.
Yeah, and you're probably getting a shot right now.
Is red.
Yeah, exactly. And when she gets scared, she'll puff up, and you can see it's pretty red.
And where is she, what is her native home?
So they're found in the rainforest, and they're found all over South America. We have actually a family of red-rumped agoutis in our Faces of the Rainforest, but Delilah here is one of our ambassador animals that goes around to in studio or to schools to teach people all about the wonderful world of animals and nature.
And that's so important to get these kids face-to-face with these different types of animals.
It really is, and you know, believe it or not, there's actually some legislation in Connecticut right now that would stop that, and we're working with other zoos and aquariums to make sure that kids always have the opportunity to meet incredible creatures like Delilah, and that we have the opportunity to come on shows like this and educate people all about the incredible world of nature.
So she's got a nut right now because she's like the squirrel of the rainforest.
They are rodents. They are rodents of unusual size, and they actually will bury nuts to find later. So it actually helps replant the whole rainforest. Their action. So pretty very useful animal.
And
She's got a special ability, Scott. I don't know if she's going to do it, but apparently she can jump 5 feet from a standing position.
Look at her stretching.
She can just leap in the air.
She's getting ready. She's doing her athletic stretches.
They actually do that when they're very scared, and they can actually jump 5 feet straight up, flip around, and then just shoot out and then run really fast. But she's one of our ambassador animals.
Yeah.
She's comfortable. We've really worked with her a lot to get her comfortable in situations like this. So, unfortunately, or maybe fortunately, she won't be doing that today.
Where did she come from? Oh, there she goes. Hi, sweetie.
Hi.
So it's an interesting story. She had her previous owner. She was a pet, and the owner.
She was a pet,
and the owner. Her situation changed at home and couldn't keep her anymore. And fortunately, the zoo was able to incorporate her into our ambassador animal program. But unfortunately, that's not usually the case. So we get calls for former pets all the time saying, "Can you take my unwanted iguana or parrot or things like
that?"
Can
you have an agouti as a pet? You're allowed to have an agouti?
Probably. You need to check all the permits, your local permits, but most likely not.
They're not good pets. They're not good pets.
And do you guys have a zoo-mobile?
We do. We actually have three zoo-mobiles that go out all around New England through all of Rhode Island, Connecticut, and Mass. And we take these incredible animals. We take the zoo on the road, actually. So we obviously love when people can come and visit us at the zoo. But if they can't make it out there, then we can bring the zoo to you.
Hi.
And the Roger Williams Park Zoo is nearby. It's just kind of over the state line a little bit. And you can really experience, because not only can you maybe meet Delilah, but other things. Like you get to feed the giraffes, and there's a lot of interactive experiences.
There really are. And, right now we're open 10 to 4 every day. And April 1st, we start going extended hours 10 to 5.
Which is great.
And,
it's coming. Right?
And spring is here, and we're so excited. Spring is such an exciting time at the zoo with new babies and new animals. And, and lots of opportunity to just really learn about these incredible creatures.
Vegetarian or meat eater?
Strictly
vegetarian.
Absolutely, yeah.
And life expectancy of,
yeah,
of an animal?
Yeah, we hope.
This?
Well, that's the thing about a zoo, right, is they can live a real long time.
Right.
So 10 to 15 years.
10 to 15 years.
Yeah,
okay,
she's
that's
three
pretty
now.
Good. She's three.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
isn't that
so
incredible?
She'll be with us a nice long time.
And the kids come and visit. They get to go through this rainforest. It's such an exciting experience. I know I went through it when it was in construction, and it's just fantastic.
And we do have a family of agouti in there. We have Pecan and who just had a baby, Gunner, and so you can see a baby agouti potentially when you come and visit as well, in addition to our ambassador like Delilah.
Love it. The agoutis have moved into the neighborhood.
She's so cute. All right, she doesn't like the rind, just like the human. She leaves the rind.
Well, she's so funny too, because what she did earlier is we gave her a pecan and she hid it because that's super special, so she's going to save that one for later. Now she's got a peanut. She'll probably eat it, but she might decide she might want to hide
she
that
knows
one too.
The peanuts are just basic and the pecan needs to be saved.
Exactly.
So no nut allergies here.
No nut allergies.
That's fantastic.
No.
Well, again, thank you guys so much for bringing in this really wonderful Delilah the agouti.
Delilah went to go hide.
On cue. on cue, she's like, I'm going to take my nut and go.
I'm done now.
All right, to plan your trip to the Roger Williams Park Zoo in nearby Providence, Rhode Island, visit rwpzoo.org. The zoo is open daily from 10 to 4 through the end of the month, and in April, it's open from 10 to 5.